Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to see the types of transformers and its applications. Basically, the transformer can be classified into two types based on the construction, the types of construction, as core type transformer and shell type transformer. The core type transformer will have the coils, and these coils may be of circular, oval or rectangular. In small size core type transformers, a simple rectangular core is used with cylindrical coils which are either circular or rectangular in form. But for large size core type transformers, round or circular cylindrical coils are used, which are so wound as to fit over a cruciform core section. The circular cylindrical coils are used in most of the core type transformers because of their mechanical strength, and such cylindrical coils are wound in helical layers with the different layers insulated from each other by paper, cloth or cooling tanks. In a core type transformer, half of the primary winding and half of the secondary winding are placed around each limb as shown in this figure. This reduces the leakage flux, and it is a usual practice to place the low voltage winding below the high voltage winding for mechanical considerations. And the next type is the shell type transformer. In shell type transformer, the coils are multi-layer disc type, usually wound in the form of pancakes. The different layers of such multi-layer discs are insulated from each other by paper. The complete winding consists of stacked discs with insulation space between the coils. The space is forming horizontal cooling and insulating ducts. A shell type transformer may have a simple rectangular form or it may have a distributed form. In shell type, the construction involves the use of a double magnetic circuit. Both the windings are placed around the central limb. The other two limbs act simply as a low reluctance path for the core. The choice of type, whether core or shell, will not greatly affect the efficiency of the transformer. The core type is generally more suitable for high voltage and small output applications, while the shell type is generally suitable for low voltage and high output applications. Next is the application of transformers. There are four major applications of transformers, namely power transformer, distribution transformers, auto transformer and instrument transformers. The instrument transformer will have further more subdivision, which is nothing but the current transformer and voltage transformer. First, let us see about the power transformer. The power transformer are used in the transmission networks of higher voltages. The ratings of the power transformer are maybe 400 kV, 200 kV, 110 kV, 66 kV and 33 kV. They are mainly rated above 200 megawatt ampere specifications. And these are mainly installed at the generating stations and transmission substations, and they are designed for a maximum efficiency of 100%. They are even larger in size as compared to the distribution transformers and are designed to operate with an utmost constant load, which is equal to their rating. The maximum efficiency is designed to be at full load. This means that the full load winding copper losses must be equal to the core losses. Next, in case of a distribution transformer, it will have low ratings like 11 kV, 6.0 kV, 6.6 kV, 3.3 kV, 440 volt and 230 volt kind of specifications. They are rated less than 200 megavolt ampere, and are used in distribution network to provide voltage transformation in the power system by stepping down the voltage level where the electrical energy is distributed and utilized at the consumer end. These transformers have variable load, which is usually considerably less than the full load rating. Therefore, these are designed to have their maximum efficiency at between half and 75% of full load. Next is the auto transformers. The standard transformers have primary and secondary windings placed in two different directions, but Nayta transformer has only one winding and is used in case where the ratio of transformation K may be either step up or step down differs a little from 1. For the same output and voltage ratio, an auto transformer requires less copper than an ordinary two winding transformer. Auto transformers are used for starting induction motors and boosters for raising the voltage of feeders. The last type, application of transformer is the instrument transformer. Instrument transformer is an electrical device used to transform current as well as voltage level. The most common use of instrument transformer is to safely isolate the secondary winding when the primary has high voltage and high current supply, so that the measuring instrument, energy meters or relays which are connected to the secondary side of the transformer will not get damaged. The instrument transformer is further divided into two types, the current and voltage transformers are used to extend the range of AC instruments. Current transformer. The current transformer is used for measuring and also for the protection. When the current in the circuit is high, to apply directly to the measuring instrument, the current transformer is used to transform the high current into the desired value of the current required in the circuit. The primary winding of the current transformer is connected in series to the main supply, and the various measuring instruments like ammeter, voltmeter, wattmeter or protective relay coil. They have accurate current ratio and phase relation to enable the meter accurately on the secondary side. The voltage transformer is a device that is used to measure high alternating voltage. It is also termed as potential transformer. The primary winding is connected across the high voltage line whose voltage is to be measured, and all the measuring instruments and meters are connected to the secondary side of the transformer. The main function of the potential transformer is to step down the voltage level to a safe limit or a value. The primary winding of the potential transformer is earth or grounded as a safety point. The power rating of a potential transformer is small since voltmeter is the only load on the transformer. This is the end of the transformer series. Thank you for watching.